into its 14th season, so why do you think it's stuck around for so long?
I think besides the fact that it's aimed at the youth of Canada, and there's a new audience every two or three years, I think one of the things that people really dug about the show is that it was never condescending. It was never preachy. Kids get preached at in school 5 days a week. They don't need to go home and have someone finger-pointing in their face. Obviously, if I hadn't been on Street Sense, then John Vision never would have happened. It was a springboard that launched me to the other things that I've done.
He was the thoughtful, sensitive guy for the first 5 seasons. Let's hope he doesn't mind a house call. Hello, Jamie Bradley. It's Street Sense knocking at your door.
How did you find me?
Street Sense scheming added a wacky edge to the show, and viewers loved it.
The snack that lasts and lasts. Vico's Nature Chips. No fats, no preservatives.
All those years of training as an unscrupulous weasel has paid off. I found my true calling. Successful network executive.
Who was Ken Pompadour?
A dark man with many secrets. No, he represented the other side of the coin. He was bad, you know, big bad business.
So how many years has it been since you left the show, and what have you been doing in those years?
Well, that was in 97, so 5 years. When I left the show, I moved to Toronto and did a variety of films, movies of the week, television things, commercials, etc., things like that. We're actually on the set of a new TV show for the Women's Network called A Guy and a Girl, and I'm directing. We're doing a lot of driving scenes today, so that's why we're in the parking lot. I'm not parking cars. Okay.
Is there anything from Street Sense that will not leave your head, brain, that's stuck there?
Yeah, the Sam Manila song. That was, we sang that against a disco rap.
How'd that go?
Jonathan started it, he's putting meat on the windowsill, and it was knock, knock.
Who's there? Sam! Sam who? Sam Manila! Big man, watch out for Sam Manila and its relatives.
Your nasty neighbors.
Working with Jonathan, Benita, Jamie, Anna, all of those, we had such a great time. It was all day long, just laughing and just going out of control.
Weren't around as long as others, but they all had their fans, and they all made a lasting impression. Field testing winter jackets 1 minute and doing an awesome commercial parody the next. Take a look.
D'Amour Bond.
Their television series for CTV called The Associates, playing a lawyer. It was great. It was another great chapter in my life. You know, we'll go a long way into wherever it is that I go from here, you know.
I heard that you got nominated for a Gemini.
Yes. Yes, I heard that too.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank
That's
you.
Awesome.
If you've got it, flaunt it.
So what are some of your favorite memories from pieces that you did or characters that you played on Street Sense?
One of the most favorite memories that stands out to me is playing RuPaul. That was fun because it was one of the most involved characters that we had to do from a makeup standpoint. You know, I shaved my legs and, you know, I remember Kathy O'Connell, our makeup artist, she did my nails and put the lashes on, the lips, the wig. The boobs.
You like that?
Oh, come on. Hey, I don't need you to tell me I look good. I know.
A brand new season on October 21st.
You know what I'm saying? J to the ROC, representing TPB, representing Street Sense.
I'll leave her with a knife. A little more Street Sense is what I need. A little less shopping is my strategy. A little less use of my debit card. A little less spending so I don't starve. A little less people running a scam. And a little less of this makes me a poor man.
We done smoking.